problem is that most political parties representatives at whatever level believe that they are the new kings of India. They behave most arrogantly and believe they have a right of way above every citizen. Shobha Dey with us tonight. YP Singh, former IPS officer, Shaina NC of the BJP, Baba Siddiqui of the Congress, Congress leader from Mumbai and MLA. Rahul Narvekar, would you first like to, I think one of your eminent leaders was also part of this group of MLAs that carried out this beating. So on behalf of your party, would you like to apologize? Not just to that policeman,
well, at the outset,
but to all the people of Maharashtra, the people of Mumbai, and the people of India, for this horrible display of political arrogance. Because if you apologize today, Rahul Narvekar, perhaps people might forgive what happened today. But if you don't, then, well, it's your choice. What would you like to do?
Well, Arnab, at the outset, I would like to state with a great sense of grief that the incident that took place today has brought absolute disgrace to this luminous institution called Maharashtra Legislative Assembly, which has always been known for its high standards of parliamentary principles, high quality of debate, also known as one of the most premium assemblies in the country today. However, incidents like this have brought utter shame to the Maharashtra Legislative Assembly. This needs to be condemned by one and all. Now, coming to your question as to whether or not my party legislature is involved in this incident, from the reports that I have got, I understand that there was a group of 30 to 40 MLAs who were present at that very moment. But there is absolutely no clarity as to who were the particular MLAs who indulged in the act of actually assaulting this policeman. Therefore, I think it would be we would be jumping the gun if we come to any sort of conclusion. Yes, but if at all any legislative member of my party is involved in this act, I am seriously, absolutely, this is unpardonable, uncalled for, and unjustified, and the party will take appropriate action with regards to that. Insofar as this whole incident is concerned,
These are very predictable, cagey, cautious, and to be honest with you, Rahul, they are unconvincing arguments that you are putting forth. You lack the courage today to say that any MLA who is participating in this terrible act should be sacked. You've not said that. Let's get Shobha Dey in. Hear a citizen's voice, please. Hear a citizen's voice, because, you know, enough is enough, Rahul. Shobha Dey, what do you think of what has happened?
Well, as we were given a little preamble to what actually took place, and we've seen it, so we didn't need Mr. Narvekar to make that little speech. We could all see for ourselves exactly how disgracefully the members behaved. But to say we will take appropriate action, I'd like to ask him what that appropriate action is going to be. Will they suspend the man? Will they expel him from the party? Will they take responsibility for his behavior? It's a bit disingenuous to talk about how do you know it was from someone from my party. How there were so many people who were part of this assault. It's almost like, why are you picking on us? That does not justify gundaism and hooliganism. We've already heard what a fantastic history we have in Maharashtra of exemplary behavior. This is anything but. Apart from all of that, Mumbai cops have become soft targets. They're being attacked over and over again by politicians. It happened at Azad Maidan as well. I'd like to understand the people who condemned those attacks at Azad Maidan, including Mr. Raj Thackeray, will he condemn this attack equally tonight? Because he was very, very strong in his point of view at that time.
And will he sack those MLAs who've done it?
What action will be taken? What action do you propose to take?
Mr. Arnab Goswami and Ms. Shobha Dey, if at all it is proved and it comes out that Shiv Sena MLAs had got nothing to do with this incident, will both of you all come on screen and apologize to the party for making baseless allegations against the party?
Please, this is not, we are not indulging in this kind of a debate here.
Mr. Rahul Narvekar, just 1 minute.
It's on camera. It's on camera, Mr. Narvekar.
Why try and be counter-aggressive tonight. It's not going to help.
So please,
I would strongly suggest. I would strongly suggest, Mr. Rahul Narvekar, allow me please, unless you have determined not to let anyone speak. Mr. Rahul Narvekar, I would strongly suggest that on your smartphone, you quickly do a Google search on who are the group of eminent politicians who have beaten up this policeman. And then find out how many press reports mention anybody from your party. Right? And then you decide how you want to respond to it. I want to go to Baba Siddiqui next. Baba Siddiqui. Your party MLA is not, you know, I don't find him listed out in this, but is it true that this particular MLA supports the ruling coalition? And is that the reason why the ruling coalition is going soft on this man who, when caught for speeding, decided to beat up the policeman?
No, I have to answer two questions, Arnav. The first one is, any sane man would condemn this incident. What happened by the MLAs. But as you say, what we were given to understand by the concerned colleague MLA, that it was his driver who was speeding, and the driver was charged for two offences, which the CD he has given it to the press also, in fact, your media also has it, and where he provoked. It is unfortunate that MLA took that task, which is regrettable. But at the same time, there is a privilege motion, which is a democratic right, which was used. I think so. That would have been a better option, which was also used. But unfortunately, all the MLAs across party lines went, which has to be condemned. And anything within the house, it is the speaker who has to initiate the probe. And I am sure the speaker is coming.
I am very sorry, Mr. Baba Siddiqui. I am very sorry, Mr. Baba Siddiqui. I think that can be a misuse of privilege. Tell me, Mr. Baba Siddiqui, you are caught for over speeding your car. I'm sorry, that's your personal problem. 1 minute. You are misusing your position as an MLA by filing a privilege against a policeman because you think he should not have caught you for one or two charges. It's a straightforward show of political strength and arrogance. YP Singh, what do you make of it? Is somebody overspeeding? A matter of privilege?
The privilege is from the 16th century by the British Parliament. Thomas More was the one who initiated, Mr. Arnav. I can't hear you.
Go ahead, teach me British politics, then I'll give you a British response.
The 16th century, that is the privilege. I am not talking about the incident, Arnav. I am talking about the privilege that has been. I have not seen the CD. You have seen the CD. So unless I see the CD, I will not be able to say the contents because I am not in a position. That is being told to us.
Mr. Baba Siddiqui,
bring the fact.
Mr. Baba Siddiqui, my question to you is whatever the provocation.
Okay. Whatever the provocation,
you have no business beating up a policeman. That's as simple as that.
No, not at all. I'm saying that. I'm on the line.
You cannot behave like gundas. Call the policeman to the assembly, file a privilege, and then thrash
him. I'm trying to tell you that we cannot. Nobody can behave like gundas, and the guilty should be punished, and the speaker should initiate a probe against this.
So. If I was to beat up a policeman, I would be in jail tonight, Baba Siddiqui.
Exactly.
If I was to beat up a policeman along with 10 people, I would be in jail tonight.
Whoever is guilty.
If I were to touch his collar, I would be in jail tonight. Why are those MLAs not in jail?
So the same is applicable to the concerned MLA, and it has to be proven.
What proof are we talking about? Is there on camera?
Oh, fantastic.
It's on YP camera.
Singh,
what,
you buy that?
What further
YP
proof?
Singh, do you buy that?
No, absolutely. What Mr. Baba Siddiqui is saying is absolutely not consistent with the law. The law is very clear. It says that if for a particular act there is a particular mode of performance stipulated under the law, that procedure alone is required to be followed and not other procedures like, oh, we regret it and we have a dismay and all these things. The procedure was very clear. It says if the police officer gets to know that a cognizable offence has been committed, he has to register FIR at once without delay. It was clearly a cognizable offense. 332 Indian Penal Code, hammering a public servant of COP. It is a non-bailable offense. COPs were required to have registered the offense at once. 157 clearly says that the COP, the officer in charge of the police station, should have gone and apprehended the culprits. Nothing of the sorts was gone. But what is more appalling to note is that our senior officers, like spineless entities, instead of ensuring the rule of law prevailed and FIR was registered, they went with folded hands before their political bosses to protest as to what is happening and to seek their guidance in the matter, when the Supreme Court has clearly laid that the supervision of the government over the police is only with reference to administration. But when the police is performing its statutory functions, that has to be done independently based on merit. I think I would blame less the MLAs, but more the spineless senior officers of the police, who did not ensure that the FIR was registered and the culprits were put behind bars. Now perhaps they are contemplating, or perhaps they have registered the FIR, but the million-dollar question is whether the 15 people against whom they are registering the FIR, will they be put behind bars? Will they be in the lockup? Will they take a police remand for 7 days to ensure that the investigation goes on well? I think this is something extremely appalling.
And if they are not, then who will have faith in governance? Okay, go ahead, Baba Siddiqui. I have to go to China and see, but you want to give a quick rebut. Make it sharp and short. Go ahead.
What he's saying, exactly what I'm saying is, in the Vidhan Bhavan premises, the speaker is supreme. He should take necessary action. That is what I'm trying to say.
No, sorry.
That's not right.
If somebody murders somebody, he doesn't get an immunity. Sorry, Mr. Siddiqui. The rule says you only have to inform the procedure after arrest. You don't have to take a permission of the speaker to arrest.
Little knowledge what I have, I feel the speaker... the speaker has to take cognizance of it and take the action.
Don't hide behind procedure.
It is a constitutional right of the speaker, that is to my knowledge. I may be wrong.
No, not at all. He only has
now
to
let me tell
somebody
you.
Rape, somebody murder.
Don't hide behind procedure. Is it true, China NC, that a Bharatiya Janata Party MLA was also part of the eminent politicians who are part of beating up this policeman? And may I ask you whether you have sacked this particular eminent politician from your party, whoever he is?
Well, let me first say that our leader of opposition, Eknath Khadse, has issued a notice. And I think we're the only political party that have chosen to act. Now, having said that, Arnab, I want to raise a bigger question, that where is our tolerance level? And especially in public life, presuming even if the police officer had been aggressive, it is the prerogative of the MLA in question to decide how he chooses to respond or react. Now, if the lawmaker is going to turn lawbreaker, and that too within the premises of the Vidhan Sabha, I think it's a shameful day for Maharashtra politics, as everyone has said. But the larger question here is that in public life, one expects lawmakers to be the ones who enact policy, yes, clearly, but who also show restraint. Because if everyone is going to react like this with officers, I answered your question. We are the only party, our leader of opposition, Mr. Eknath Khadse, has sent a notice. Arnab, I did reply. The first thing I said is that our leader of opposition, Eknath Khadse, has sent a notice. But clearly there is a CCTV footage which needs to be viewed. And tomorrow, if he is guilty, he will be brought to task.
What is a notice?
A notice
what
is...
What is a notice worth?
1 minute.
What is a notice
minute.
Worth? You give
I'd
him a
like
notice,
to say, say
he replies
that everyone,
to the notice,
one
you
second.
Say very bad,
Arnab, when
please don't
everyone
do it again.
Else
life,
is discussing...
Till you beat the next policeman.
When everyone else is going on this argument that we need to prove this person guilty or not, we are saying the CCTV footage is there, and tomorrow you will know if he was guilty or if he was just a bystander. Now, clearly, you can have that as a logical argument from
our
point of view.
Who will determine that? Who will determine that?
The CCTV footage will show.
I don't understand. I don't understand what you're hiding behind.
1 minute. I am not for 1 minute shielding anyone who is guilty.
A policeman, 1 minute. I'm sorry, China, you're on very weak ground tonight. You're on extremely weak ground. You're saying there's an investigation. I'm saying it has been proven because the protagonists have admitted we did beat up the policeman. They're saying we were provoked into beating. But it has been proven that they beat up the policeman. What is this whole inquiry and notice all about? You see the policeman out there. He's taken in an ambulance. He's been thrashed black and blue by a group of MLAs. What investigation is required?